watching breakfast television. And now, here are the main points again.
The Soviet Union. 47-year-old Mikhail Gorbachev is the youngest party member ever to hold a full seat on the Politburo. His duties will include the streamlining of agricultural methods, speeding up grain distribution, and wheeling the other members around the park on Sunday.
And as the tension mounts for Jimmy Carter, his doctors warn him to cut down on his daily intake of tranquilizers.
Back home now, and a British Rail catering manager has been dismissed after he was caught loading a train with more than the regulation amount of sausage rolls.
Mr. Kurt Waldheim has decided to resign as head of the United Nations so that he can concentrate on running his brother-in-law's laundrette. From Harrow on the Wheel went into their local electricity board showroom to buy a new fridge freezer.
They paid cash for it, and within 4 days it was installed and took pride of place in their kitchen.
All went well for a couple of weeks.
The milk was cold.
The food stayed fresh.
And even the light worked when you opened the door.
But then the trouble started.
On February the 19th, the Robinson's 7-year-old son, George, got an attack of appendicitis and had to be rushed to hospital.
They rang the electricity board, who responded,
"This has got nothing to do with us."
The Robinsons left it at that, but this incident was just the tip of the iceberg.
Just 2 days after this, on the 17th, a freak typhoon ripped off a whole side of their house, 79 Latchmere Road.
Well, naturally upset by this, Mr. and Mrs. Robinson had a quarrel, which ended in Mr. Robinson savagely pushing his wife through a plate glass window.
On both occasions, they contacted the electricity board, and on both occasions, they were told,
"I'm sorry, this really has got nothing to do with us."
It was then that things began to go seriously wrong.
Mr. Robinson ran his car into a bus queue and was shot by a police marksman.
Mrs. Robinson was attacked by a killer whale.
Mr. Robinson's mother was hit by a meteorite.
Prince Philip exploded.
President Carter formally declared war with the Soviet Union.
And I was arrested on the street and charged with causing an obstruction. It was then that we contacted the electricity board. The young man who answered the phone seemed rather confused. He said,
"I'm sorry, this really has got nothing to do with us."
Cyril.
I'm indebted to a gentleman from Swansea who wrote to tell me that his television entertainment is constantly ruined by the appearance of a camp old twat who continuously reads his appalling drivel over the air. Well, all I've got to say to you is this has nothing to do with me.
have a biro, please? Thanks. Thanks very much.
Drove like that on a public highway, you deserve to be called a raving maniac. 5 years I was in the police force, and quite honestly, I've never seen anybody drive in quite...
Just a second. Sir Robert, that was fine. That was fine.
Yes.
There's just one small thing. If you could emphasise the road safety aspect of it slightly more than you were there in your own words, if you could emphasise the fact that tyres are more about safety than about danger, if you remember your script,
yes.
I'm convinced that this is a major contribution to road safety. Let's try it just on your spot there. Okay, let's rehearse it, and
yes.
Rehearsal.
I am convinced that this is...
That's right.
I'm convinced that this is a major contribution to...
To road safety.
I am convinced.
You are?
I am convinced that this is a major contribution to road safety.
The High Street, and today saw the opening of the country's first drive-in opticians. At a party to celebrate her 55th birthday last week, Mrs. Thatcher blew on the cake and lit the candles.
And the recent mysterious disappearance of Sir Keith Joseph was explained today when he was found looking for the other half of his moustache.
And members of the Voluntary Euthanasia Society, Exit, today went on their annual outing to Morecambe.
Leonard Brezhnev paid a short visit to Poland today, where he was guest of honour at a banquet held by the Friends of the Soviet Union.
Hello. I'm sorry to interrupt the flow of things here, but I'd like to announce my candidacy for the presidency of the United States of America. I know I've come into this a little late. Oh, is that the time? That was just a little joke. I only decided to run this morning. You see, I've always wanted to be president, and my friend Milburn said that it would be a fun thing for me to do, so he's going to be my running mate. I could crack another joke there, but I can't think of one. Anyway, when he first suggested I should run, I said, that's a very interesting suggestion, Milburn, but perhaps to be ruled out on the grounds of my stupidity, which is considerable. I really have no brains at all. It's amazing. But Milburn says that someone ought to do something, because he can't understand how we can look around our nation of 500 million clever people and decide that only Jimmy Carter or Ronald Reagan could possibly lead us. He thinks that's amazing. Not that I'm going to be abusing those other candidates. I respect them both and look forward to meeting them in the near future, and perhaps even getting their autographs. I feel we have a lot in common. Our simple-mindedness will be an especially powerful bond. But mine, over in England, Milburn says that one of their parties is choosing a new leader, and apparently their candidates are just awful. It seems to be the same everywhere. They've all got this hair problem, you know? That just doesn't seem to be the choice these days. Anyway, my name's Richard Head. Hello. And my motto is vote for Dickhead, so you don't get a dickhead for president. Now you may ask, what am I gonna do when I move into the White House? What are you gonna do when you move into the White House? You know, I thought I'd paint it pink. Because pink is a very friendly color, and then it will be the Pink House, which is far less liable to racist interpretation than the White House. So, think pink is another one of my slogans. You may also wonder who will be the first lady when I'm elected. Well, I intend to take the name literally. So the first lady to ring this number can be the first lady for the duration. And frankly, I'm not all that fussy. And that's another one of my slogans. Dickhead's not all that fussy about his... I think I withdraw that one. Sorry. I withdraw that one. And instead I have dickhead-like slogans. Do you like dickhead? Well, I hope you do. Vote for me, I'm cute.
This summer, Mr. and Mrs. Watkins set off on holiday without paying their television license. The Gilbert family forgot to pay their license too, so we sent them a little reminder on their wedding anniversary. It's no use running away. We're a large organisation and we've got plenty of time. As Mr. Aylett of Basildon found out. So get a license. It's cheaper than a funeral.
There now follows a government statement on the current employment figures.
Oh, dear. Oh, dear, oh, dear, oh, dear. Oh, God.
A very good morning to you. I'll have a jar of Keep It Up cream, please. Actually, no, on second thoughts, make that two jars. Only I'm feeling a bit randy this week. And I'll have a large rubber inflatable woman. My old one's getting a bit flat. Ah, dear.
Morning.
Ah! I see you stock the new cock-a-doodle dandy. Any good, are they?
I don't know, I've never...
Look, I say, have any of you tried one of these?
No, please.
I'm thinking of buying one.
Please. What? You're annoying my customers.
What? Look, I'm not annoying you by asking you if you've tried one of these, am I? Dr. Lewis! Hello there! You've dropped your rampant bull jelly.
Please!
But he's dropped his rampant bull jelly.
Would you mind keeping your voice down?
It's jolly expensive stuff. You know, he's going to be very annoyed when he gets home. Now, I'll have a gross of the contraceptives, please. The black ones with the end shaped like a six-shooter. Midnight Cowboy, I think they're called. They're marvellous if you've got a small one. I've got a small one. Tiny. What about you? You look to me the sort of chap who's got a right John Bindon down there. You must meet my wife, Chloe, darling. Come in and meet the Albert Memorial.
How do you do?
Darling, have you got any Casanova pellets?
Yes, I've got a kilo in the trolley.
Now, you see, we've got the party tonight, darling. We might need more... The party. You must come to the party. In fact, everybody should come to... Oh. I expect you'll get a lot of that, dear. People coming in and not buying anything.
Bless me, Father, for I have sinned. It's a week since my last confession. Father? Are you there, Father?
Father Patrick is out at the moment. You can leave your confession by speaking clearly through the window, and he'll forgive you when he gets back. Please speak after the tone.
pub. We've seen one, yeah. It was about 10:30 at night, yeah, I suppose. We were coming back from the pub, and it was a very clear evening, and suddenly it was just there, this huge, huge thing.
Yeah, incredible. It had rows of lights all down the side, didn't it? Yeah, double
sort of,
row.
Yes, yeah, so yeah. Just two layers of lights then. But it was incredible. I mean, it was actually only with us for a second, you know.
Yeah,
I mean, it just sort of flashed past like a streak of lightning, really, didn't it?
We didn't get a really close look, but it was cigar-shaped.
Yeah. Well, no, it wasn't so much cigar-shaped. It was kind of... It was more... Oh, look, there's another one. Look there, look.
Relax, okay, fine. Hi, come in. I'll take that, shall I? And you won't be wanting that either, will you? That wasn't too bad, was it? Now, come in and meet the others.
Oh, good Lord, is that the time? I've got a meeting to go
yes,
to.
Yes, Peter, you have got a meeting, yes. Here, at Workaholics.
No, I think you've got the wrong person.
Listen, shall I take the clipboard?
I don't work a lot, honestly. I don't really work now. I don't really work. Yes, I do. I'm a workaholic. God, okay. I need help.
Sit down. You're amongst friends here, Peter. Amongst friends here. Betty. Betty's a manic housewife. Fred here was a 24-hour plumber. I was an insatiable hairdresser. We all know your story, Peter. When did you start? What, 17, was it?
16.
Yeah, and you were still at school, right?
Yeah.
I bet there was a careers master involved there somewhere, wasn't there?
And I suppose there were a couple of older guys who were into shift work, yeah?
Well, I didn't like it at first, you see.
But it was the manly thing to do,
it was
wasn't
the
it?
The manly yeah. thing to do.
And it was about then that you were OT'd, right?
Yeah.
That's pretty stupid, Peter, isn't it? Overtime at your age?
Yes, all right, yes, okay.
What about your wife?
Yes, she left me.
Yeah?
She couldn't stand me coming home night after night reeking of money.
Yeah, so what did you do?
I used to pretend I'd been down the pub. I'd suck Guinness lozenges to try and disguise where I'd been.
And the secret working?
The secret working.
Yes, the calculator
hidden in the lavatory
system. The typewriter ribbons?
The typewriter ribbons in the icebox.
The cuddly toy?
The cuddly toy and the, you know, the casserole thing. And
The fondue set.
And finally, she caught me trying to stuff a telex machine in the wardrobe.
It's the demon. It's the demon work that's being thrust at us from all corners. Because it's a big business these days, isn't it? Work, the big combines, the Manpower Services Commission. Down every high street, the big welcoming sign above the door, the job centre. Creaking gaily in the work-infested air. Oh, God, I need a job.
You don't need a job, Fred. You don't. Thousands have stuck it out. So can you. Look. Over 2 million cured. Listen, I think we all need one of these. Go on, take one. I think we all need one of these. Go on. I took... No, I'll get it. Hi, can I...
Hello, Miss Hornby. Look, take a left, will you? Sir, I read yours at the fourth.
No, please, no! You mad fool! Peter, you're amongst friends now.
I know. I'm fine now that I'm here with you, but what happens when I get home? I get this sudden urge to just go out and do a bit of adding or something.
Well, listen, Peter, if that happens, I want you to ring this number,
yeah,
and we'll all come round and get you pissed out of your brain.
Industrial news now, and Liverpool Dockers today called off their threatened action and have now agreed to handle Barbara Streisand's snuff box.
A man was arrested today on suspicion of stealing the Queen's handbag. He was later released after she failed to pick him out at an identity parade.
Aspinall was forced to shoot another exhibit at his zoo yesterday after it bored its keeper to death.
I like trucking. be brave and tireless.
On the road,
you can listen to the wireless.
On the road,
you eat cafe food with pride. You can throw it outside.
The greatest kick in trucking, apart from knocking down a biker, is swinging off a roundabout and picking up a hiker. You're chatting up that piece of skirt who's sitting by your side, then pop the crucial question:
a ride for a ride.
Well, I'll be buggered if I go out there tonight.